morning. Hello. When I shout hello, you respond hi. Hello.
Hi.
You see, when I woke up at home a few days ago before I came here, the temperature was 27 in the morning. By noon, it was 35. This 10 degrees is killing me. And I have absolutely no energy. So I need you to energize me a little bit more just by clapping for me before you hear the presentation. Please, please, please. Okay. Okay. We haven't solved all the problems in the health sector. So let me put that out first. It's still a mess. It's still a very complicated space. We haven't solved all the problems. So I'm not going to present that we solved all the problems. But I will share my experiences in how appreciating that there is a system has supported us to do the things we have to do. When I was a much junior physician and things went wrong, we would huddle and say, the system is not working. And the system is not doing this. And it's about the system. But absolutely nobody could define what that monster called the system was. So we kept experiencing the same things and complaining that the system is not working. There is evidence of the impact of good water and sanitation and hygiene on health outcomes. I mean, it's clear. And there is also evidence that having good water, sanitation, hygiene in a healthcare facility does support care outcomes. Patients are happier, work gets done, services happen, everybody is happy and good to go. But it's funny that we don't think about wash in a meaningful way in the healthcare facility, even though we are aware of the benefits of it to what we do. So the challenge has been, how do we institutionalize? How do you make sure that wash and wash issues becomes a way of life? Not an add-on, not somebody trying to convince us that this is important. Within the health systems, WHO defines 6 blocks. Leadership and governance, health information, services we deliver, financing medical products, vaccines and technologies. And WHO Afro said, well, that's good. We do like the 6, but we have a unique situation, a unique context on the continent, and we need to recognize the community and its ownership and participation in what we do. We need to recognize partnership development, specifically for health. And above all, we need to have evidence that informs what we do, and therefore research for health became a significant area and thematic when we discuss health and health issues on the continent and back at home. This framework is global, it's national, it's regional, it's facility-based. It's exactly the same system, but how it operates at a different level are slightly different. But it has basically the same components. Okay. We say in systems that a system is perfectly designed to deliver the results that it gives you. So if there is no water in the hospital, then the hospital is perfectly designed to have absolutely no water running. It is what it is. Systems theory will tell you 80-90% of what goes wrong is not about the people, it's about the system. What exists and what doesn't exist. What guides what we do and what does not guide us what we do. And that's the fundamental premise upon which all this sets out. Let me give you an example, not in WASH. Now, I'm managing a hospital, it's a 2,000-bed facility, teaching hospital, and the Department of Medicine realizes that we're having a lot of renal issues, kidney problems, and they decide to start dialysis in the hospital. So they champion it, send a few physicians to train. We have a dialysis unit. That's fantastic. Then along the line, someone idiot says, well, these guys have been on dialysis for 10 years and more. We should be doing renal transplants. Now the Department of Surgery realizes that we don't have any transplant surgeons. And this is 5 years after dialysis has been running. So now they send somebody off to do transplant surgery who comes back after 5 years. And then realize, well, you know, we didn't prepare the theater to receive a transplant surgeon. Now this is 10 years down the line. We haven't achieved what we actually set out to do. But the question is, what did we set out to do? Did we set up to have a dialysis program running? Or we set out to improve care outcomes for persons with renal conditions? And the system issue is about the outcome, not the output. What is the ultimate result that we want to see? We talk of sensitivity and responsiveness to generate a resilient health system. And if I situate WASH in that context, sensitivity means that the health system, the hospital, the health facility is able to identify deviations from the expected standards of WASH. Is it able to? Where responsiveness is, when it does recognize that, hey, there's no water running, there's taps are not functioning, does it have the capacity to intervene and do something about it? And all this is in the context of the various blocks. Do you have a governance system? Do we have a leadership system that allows us to fill in these blanks? What is the intent and purpose? There must be a purpose. The bottom line for the healthcare facility is a healthy people. The bottom line for a health facility is that people come in and they get well when they leave. Unfortunately, it's not about WASH. The manager of the health facility doesn't think WASH. He thinks patients and people who come in, what we do to them, and what happens to them when they leave. So WASH, at the level of operations in the health sector, and I dare say at the facility level, is about, does it contribute to my bottom line? And that is probably the only way I will listen and buy in and take it on to look at WASH. Until then, I'm busy treating malaria, I'm busy doing caesarean sections, I'm busy doing other things. So the real learning here is, how do you make WASH attractive? How does it support my bottom line? At that level, the system must have a bigger purpose than the outputs. It must have a bigger purpose than number of taps, number of buckets, water running 24/7. It must have a bigger purpose. Systems are not designed primarily for outputs. A sustainable system is designed for outcomes, the end result. It must be able to generate buy-in in the facility level, at all levels. It must be able to generate commitment of all those involved at all levels. It must be able to have capacity continuously in a sustainable manner all the time. The system must be able to do that. All those components of governance, human resources, information technology, financing, research, community ownership must all be tweaked at the same time. And I think you made an issue, the diagnosis. Are the systems WASH fit? Are the systems WASH compliant? Is the health system, the health facility, will it able to ensure safe water, equitable distribution of water within the facility? Will it be able to make sure that it meets the user needs at the right place at the right time? Do I have water running in the theater? Do I have water running in the wards? It should be able to make sure that I get the water at the right time, in the right quality. So when you come in and you speak WASH to me, and I don't get it, and I don't see how it supports me to achieve this, it's a nice discussion. And when you come in and you say, okay, we know we need to do a borehole, we need to do a this, we need to do a that, how are all those systemic components aligned to enable that to happen for me in the facility? So we say, my governance system must be able to be responsive and sensitive. Do I have a policy, even in my institution, that lends itself to water sanitation and hygiene? Do I have mechanisms from a governance perspective that will allow me to respond and how? Do I know the impact of good water and sanitation, or the lack of it thereof, on what my bottom line is, care outcomes and patients? Do I have people who understand WASH in the facility space and who have the capacity to let it happen? I remember there's this 400-bed ward, maternity unit. They tell me there's no water running. I'm like, how come there's no water running? And I had no idea how the system works, not knowing that there's this little pump that is sitting there which needs $50 just to change a capacitor. But the system is not aware, it's not sensitive, and there's a whole outcry in the environment. Do we know, as it were, what it costs? Do we even have a budget line to support WASH in the health facility environment? It's good to come in with a project. This is the money, we're going to build it for you. But if you leave me without me tweaking my system to continuously recognize it, you'll be back in 6 months and tell me, how come this is broken down? But I never had a system in the financing system that recognized that I needed to recognize that I need to have funding and a finance stream to support it, or the time when WASH or the supporters, the funding agencies leave. Partnership is phenomenal, it's key. The pre-facility work is totally not in my hands. There's a local government, there are other people responsible for that. We don't have the capacity. We need to have the capacity. We need to work with other people to be able to do that. Community ownership. Here, the community becomes the workers themselves. How do we get that level of appreciation? How do we get their feedback? How do we get them all to appreciate what has to be done? And the evidence of what has to be done. Now, the challenge is, I've been here yesterday, and I've seen the WASH system, and the various components of the system. But the truth of the matter is, when you come to hit me where I am, you need to understand my system. And you need to help me to use my system in the way it is to achieve the objects of your various system components. If not, we have a clash of systems. And if I'm the beneficiary, well, I'm sorry, you want to use my systems. Because I'm not going to totally transform my hospital to be a WASH hospital. It's not going to happen. So how are you going to work with me so that my governance system is responsive to the things I need to do and incorporate it? How do you work with me to understand I need a certain level of technology, so I add it to my technology system? And I dare say this is the same concept as you escalated to local government systems, national government systems. You're clear with the processes, which is fine. We need to share the outcomes. We need to be on the same page. WASH in healthcare facility requires a systems transformation. It's not a drop in the bucket. I need to change 9 components of my system, and you need to help me to do that. WASH in healthcare facility is an integral part of the work we do. And for it to be sustainable, that system we talk about is about governance, it's about the human resource capacity, it's about funding and financing and how I do it to support it. It's about having data to give me evidence what is happening and what I need to do. It's about partnering with you, with government, and building my capacity to do that. It's about engaging with the people in the space, doing my advocacy to my own. And most importantly, it's about supporting me to achieve my bottom line, which is when you come to that facility, when you hit the health sector, and we work on you, you come out much better than you came in. Thank you.